Now, what does that exactly mean? Well, as a self-help county, a sales tax would need to be passed by local voters, which COG is proposing for this year's November election. Self-help also means that not only would the funds be generated locally, but that we would have local control on how the funds are spent, the types of projects that would be delivered, their schedule, as well as their scope of work. And as Supervisor Botella mentioned, the status, self-help status basically also helps the San Benito County area to be able to really leverage these funds. So as we apply for state and federal funding sources, we will be able to hopefully secure additional funds on a local level. And lastly, a sales tax would mean more local jobs. So that's important as well. So how much would a sales tax generate locally? Well, the Council of Governments has identified our overall transportation need of $1.8 billion. It's not showing on this slide, I'm not really sure why. over the next 22 years. However, we do expect to receive about $1.1 billion within the San Benito region over that same time frame, leaving us with a $700 million funding shortfall over the next 22 years. As a result, the COG board is considering a 1 cent sales tax over the next 30 years that would generate over $490 million. Some of the high priority projects that the board is considering for the local sales tax measure include some high capacity projects such as Highway 25, as well as new local roads and maintenance of the existing roadway network, in addition to other projects. So in order for San Benito County to become a successful self-help county, we would require two-thirds voter approval. COG would also need to prepare an expenditure plan, which outlines what specific projects would be funded with the tax measure. In addition to that, the measure will include policies, taxpayer safeguards, as well as the establishment of an oversight committee to ensure continued community involvement. And speaking of community involvement, the COG board is hosting a public meeting this Saturday at 1 p.m. at the County Board of Supervisors Chamber, so we welcome everyone to attend. I placed some flyers on your table, so please feel free to pick one up. And then as far as the next steps of the process, we will be conducting a public poll in February, finalizing the expenditure plan and final ballot question in June. Ordinance approval by the local jurisdictions in, I'm sorry, the expenditure plan in May, and the ordinance approval in June. In August, we will need to submit all of that information to the Elections Department. And of course, Election Day, November of this year. So that concludes my update. I provided Mary Gilbert, our Executive Director's contact information, as she's the primary contact for the San Benito sales tax, but if you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them at this time.